And now we will learn how to record receiving rent with the security deposit. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. This will give a separate check for the security deposit and then give another check for the first 1 or 2 months' rent. Usually we get one check from the tenant that covers both the deposit and the first month's rent. Here's situation one. Two separate checks. We would record the check for the rent normally the way that we learned, and we would even record the check for the deposit normally, except you must choose the security deposit account at the moment you record the payment. So here's an example. Let's imagine on January 1 of 2020, Gary Greenstein, who's already on the tenant list, moves into apartment 7G, and let's imagine his monthly rent is $800. He gave you two checks on January 1. Check 1983 for $800. This was specifically for the security deposit. Then he gave you on the same day check 1984 for January's rent, and they were both $800 checks. So let's take a look at how we would record this. We open the payments window just like we did before, and of course we're going to put the date. We're imagining it's January 1 of 2020. And of course the new tenant that we already put on the list is Gary Greenstein, and he gave us check number 1983, and it specifically said in the memo for January rent. So that check for $800 is January rent. So that's normal, which means we must leave the unearned rental income receivable account here because we did not earn January's rent on January 1. We will soon. So that's a separate $800 check, save and new. Click OK. Now, for the other check, the check for the deposit, it's still January 1, and it's still Gary Greenstein, and it's a different check number. He actually gave check number 1984, and check number 1984 was for $800, but it is not unearned rent. Check number 1984 is specifically for the security deposit, so we will instead choose security deposits payable. Now you can put in the memo security deposit for Gary Greenstein. Now when we click save and close and click OK, you can see on the trial balance security deposit payable shows up for the first time as $800. And if you look at the specific security deposit report, you see only Gary Greenstein, nobody else. Now this situation is probably the one you would expect. You receive one check in total for both the security deposit as well as the first 1 or 2 months' rent. If that's the case, you must enter this same check twice. The deposit amount goes into the security deposit account, and the remainder goes into the normal unearned rent account. It's very, very simple. So here's an example. On January 1, 2020, Harry Houdini, already on the tenant list, by the way, moves into apartment 8H, and let's say his monthly rent is $900. He gave you one check on January 1, check number 6611, for $1,800. And this was for both the security deposit and the January rent. Again, you must enter this same check twice. The deposit amount goes into the security deposit account, and the remainder goes into the normal unearned rent account. Let's take a look. So we click payment, and luckily it remembers that we're on January 1 of 2020, and the check amount is $1,800, push tab. And of course, the tenant is the new one, Harry Houdini in 8H. Now, the first check will be for the normal rent, or the first entry will be for the normal rent. So we will leave unearned rental income, and we will put check number 6611, and then you can put half check for rent, or anything in the memo that helps you. Now again, be careful. We're imagining that you're depositing this on the same day, so you're not using the undeposited feature, and we're pretending. So the payment amount is not correct. Even though the check's total was $1,800 over here, we have to enter it twice. We have to put $900 here. So I made a mistake a minute ago. Only put $900, because only $900 is unearned rent, and it's only for only half the check is rent. Then click Save and New and do the exact same thing. Again, it's Harry Houdini, but this time it will go into security deposit payable. So you put the same $900 and you put the same check number. That's very important, that you put the same check number so we know what's going on when we get the bank statement. This half for deposit, or whatever you want to put that helps you. Now when we click Save and Close and click OK, we'll look at the security deposit report, and you see the security deposit report shows only Gary Greenstein's deposit without messing up any of his rent. It shows only Harry Houdini's security deposit without messing up his rent, and the total equal $1,700, which is equal in the trial balance to the general ledger account that we created, security deposits payable. So we have achieved our goal of separating out the deposits and having one account that shows you the total of everybody's deposit. Now we're all set and we know how to do it. However, let's explore the reports a little more deeply. If we look at the other tenant balance detail, the one that just only says rent balances, if we scroll down to the two last tenants, you can see that it's only showing the unearned rent part, not anything to do with the security deposits over here. So it's better to rely on this rent balances report rather than the main one. If you go to the main one that we were using the whole time, this one is not filtered. So if you go all the way down, this will be the one that kind of mixes the tenant's rent or the unearned rent mixed with the security deposit. So keep that in mind. You have three separate tenant balance details, and keep in mind what they show.